How are you, students of Chitra Mahila Degree College? First year and second year students, especially the second year students, we hoped our college would open, but the reality is that our college will not be opened for increasing infection, increasing attack of coronavirus. So, you know, we are now staying with a great tension that corona, whether we will be attacked by coronavirus or not. So, students, try to stay at home, and staying at home, try to prepare yourself for the examination. You have already got rearranged syllabus, and following rearranged syllabus, you are now going a great extent. So, students, for this purpose, for that purpose, today I will take a class. One completing sentence. You know, previously, in your previous syllabus, the marks of completing sentence was only 5. But now, in your syllabus, you have to attend 7 questions. You have to attend 7 questions, and the marks distribution of completing sentence is 7. So, you should pay attention to learn completing sentence. At first, you should know the aim or objectivity of completing sentence. Many of you think completing sentence is a difficult item, so many of you don't try to learn completing sentence, and also many of you try to escape or leave completing sentence. I think the students who try to leave completing sentence are not wise person. And on the other hand, you can say that they are foolish person, foolish student, because without learning completing sentence, your grammatical structure, sentence, the structure of sentence will not be developed. And without learning the structure of sentences, no student will be able to write something from his own. And for that purpose, they try to memorize any topic, and in the exam hall, they fail to recall the themes or subject matters what they memorized before. So, in the examination hall, they fail to write their memorized thing properly, and then feel puzzled, and also carry a sorry figure in the examination hall. So, if you pay attention to learn completing sentence, and if you pay attention of the structure of the sentences, then your writing capacity will be developed, and through this writing capacity, you will be able to write down any topic where you have to write in the exam or examination hall. So, through my discussion, I think all of you are now able to understand what importance the completing sentence is. Understand? So, try to learn completing sentence properly. In this item, I think you have been attending this item from previous classes. But there is a difference in intermediate level, in SSC level or previous level, in completing sentence, you are allowed to put any kinds of word, any kinds of phrase, any kinds of clauses. That means by putting any word, clause or phrases, if the sentence is meaningful, then your purpose will be served. But in intermediate level, you have some restrictions. The restrictions is you have to use only phrase or clauses, not a word. Try to understand the point, student. You have to use only phrase and only clause. For example, we can say that I am making the discussion more clear by giving example. This is a completing sentence. Here, a gap space is well known to all. In previous classes, if you put a single word, the sentence will be allowed. Suppose, it is well known to all. Understand, student? If you use he, it was a correct sentence for SSC level or previous level, but in intermediate level, if you write down only he is well known to all, the sentence is correct, but you won't get marks because there is a condition. The condition is you have to complete the sentence either using a phrase or using a clause. So if you want to get marks, you have to write down a phrase. If you write down his personality is known to all. Understand, student? His personality is known to all. It's a phrase. And you have used one and two words. These two words together make a group. Understand? So, it's a phrase. So, if you write down his personality is known to all, then your answer is correct and you will get marks. But if you only put he, though the sentence is correct, you won't get marks. So it's a phrase. But if you want to use clause, then what will be the answer? What he says is well known to all. What he says or said. What he says or what he said is well known to all. So here, what he says or what he said is a clause. So if you write down what he said is well known to all, then your answer is correct because you have used a clause. Understand, student? So, from my discussion, I think now feel, you are now feeling a desire. What desire? Desire is learning about what is fresh and what is close, isn't it? I think it is. So, now I am discussing about the difference about what is fresh and what is close. A phrase or a clause, both are part of sentence. In this regards, both are same. This is the similarity. What is the similarity of phrase and clause? The similarity is phrase and clause both are part of a sentence. Understand, students? So, it is the similarity of phrase and clause. And another similarity also present. The similarity is both are formed. Both are formed by a group of words, not a single words. That means a phrase contains a group of words and a clause also contains a group of words. Understand, student? This is also the similarity. So, what are the similarity? The similarity is a phrase is formed by a group of words and a clause is also formed by a group of words. A clause is also formed by a group of words. So, this is the similarity. And another similarity is both are the part of a sentence. Okay, now the great point. The great point is what is the dissimilarity of a noun and clause, or by what we will be able to identify which part is a phrase and which part is a clause. The difference is that a clause doesn't a phrase doesn't contain a finite verb or subject and finite verb. Understand? A phrase doesn't contain finite verb, but a clause always contains a finite verb. In other words, or easy sense, we can say that a clause always holds a tense, but a phrase never holds a tense. You know what is tense? So, finite verb makes tense. So, the matter is same. The matter is not different. Understand? Subject matter is not different. So, I try to make you more understandable saying again the matter is the clause contains finite verb, but a phrase doesn't contain finite verb. In other words, we can say that a clause contains tense, but a phrase doesn't contain finite verb. Understand, students? Now, thinking that what he says, it's a clause. So, here finite verb is says or said, and he is the subject of that finite verb. So, what he says is a clause. And my previous example, personality. Understand, student? His personality. Here, his is a word, personality is another word, but it's a group of words. But in this group of words, no finite verb stays. Here,
his is a possessive case, personality is a noun. Understand? In another word, we can say that his is a pronoun and personality is a noun. But here, says is a verb, and not only verb, it's also a finite verb because it has made a tense. He says, the tense is present indefinite tense, and if the verb is said, the tense is past indefinite tense. So it's a clause. So we can say that if a tense stays in a part of a sentence, then we can say that the part of that sentence is a clause, and if finite verb doesn't stay, we can say the part of that sentence, part of that sentence, that means this is a sentence, part of that sentence is called phrase. Understand, students? So you should learn the basic difference of these two things, what is phrase and what is clause, because in your exam hall, if you want to complete this sentence or task this item, you have to put either a phrase or a clause. Understand, students? So now, if you want to do better in this item, you should learn the classification. Understand? The classification of clause and phrases. So now, in this class, I will start the classification, and next class I will continue the classification. At first, I will classification the clause. We can classify clause into three types. Only three types. One, noun clause. Two, adjective clause. And three, adverbial clause. Understand, students? So, noun clause. What is noun clause? The answer is very easy. A noun puts in as a subject of a sentence, and a noun puts as an object of a sentence, and a noun also puts as the prepositional object. So clause also puts the same way. Understand, students? Where a noun puts, a noun clause also puts, because a noun clause together perform the same duty of a noun. That means the part of a sentence also perform the duty of a parts of a speech, noun. So that type of clause is called noun clause. Suppose noun may be used as subject, may be used as object, and may be used for prepositional object. Understand, students? So what is subject clause? I have already written down the example. Suppose is well known to all. It's the predicate of a sentence. But
What is the absence of this sentence? The absence of this sentence is subject. So, what he says? This clause has been used as the subject of this verb, is verb. Understand? So, what he says clause is called noun phrase, noun clause, and the noun clause has been put, or noun clause has put as the subject of this sentence. So we can say that what he says is a noun clause. Now, students, come here, object. I could not understand. Here you have to complete the sentence, then we can write, I could not understood what he said. I could not understand what he said. So here, what he said is has been put as the object of the sentence. I could not understand. I could not understand what? What I could not understand? So, if you ask a question with what, then the answer is object. So, we have made a question, what he could not understand, what I could not understand, the answer is what he said. So, what he said has been put, or has put here as the object. So, this kind of word is called object of a sentence. So, it's called object of noun. That means, this clause has been put here as an object of a sentence. In this way, prepositional object, he comes of a good family. Understand? Here, preposition is of, and after preposition, a good family has puts. So, this a good family has put after this preposition. After the preposition of. So, a good family is called prepositional noun clause, or noun clause used as preposition. Okay, student, next class I will try to discuss about the classification of adject and adverbial clause. In this way, try to attend my class and try to learn about completing sentence to make your English and learning more perfect and more understandable. Understand? So, I invite you to attend my next class. Thanks.